Now, I've been one of the probably few people who have been going around for about 10 years saying that we should actually dilate, that is, do balloon angioplasty on non-significant plaques. I always used to say that looking for the hemodynamic significance in corneal angioplasty means barking up the wrong tree. We should look for the risk of a given lesion to cause a heart attack and death after it has been detected. And this is completely independent of the severity of the lesion. Although more severe lesions have a little bit a higher individual risk of causing a subsequent infarction, every mild lesion can do the same if the plaque becomes unstable. And the instability of the plaque does really not correlate very well with the significance of the stenosis it is producing. Now, the question of whether all these lesions should be treated with a drug-eluting stent is clearly not one that I would answer with a yes. I always said we should balloon dilate it, rupture the plaque, do what nature does spontaneously but under controlled circumstances, and then let new endothelium cover this new laceration that we've done with balloon dilatation. But I always say don't stent it, because if you do not stent it, the risk of subsequent occlusion is practically zero. A balloon dilated lesion never occludes unless during the acute dilatation process. But if it re-stenosis, it will go, may even come to 95-99% stenosis. It will not occlude because it's a smooth endothelium rather than a plaque that may rupture that causes re-stenosis. Now, if you insert the stent, this changes the picture a bit. As we all know, stents may subacutely thrombose even at weeks after the insertion. So I always said plaque sealing with balloon is something I would do in a non-significant lesion if it is strategically importantly placed, say in a proximal LAD, in a proximal large right. But I would not stent it unless after ballooning it looks so ugly that you have to stent it. Now, with the drug-eluting stent, of course, people think that re-stenosis is out of the picture, so they can safely treat all these non-significant lesions, but they will introduce an uncertainty for several weeks where subacute thrombosis may occur, and this may be even more frequent than spontaneous plaque rupture in the era of everybody having aspirin and statin nowadays, which does stabilize the plaques and all the plaques at a time.